Well, we knew this was probably coming. I knew I was probably going to be doing this video, if not today, sometime this week. The Kirk Cousins era of Minnesota Vikings football is officially over. He has signed, or maybe officially signed, but I mean agreed to a deal with the Falcons. Just getting the particulars out of the way. They just before I hit record, I saw the numbers on this deal, and we were never going to come close to this deal. We may never find out what the Vikings offer was, you know, their standing offer was, but I guarantee it wasn't anything close to what Atlanta gave him. He gave him it was a 4-year deal. I don't think we were ever going to go. I doubt we were even going to go to 3. We certainly weren't going to go to 4. And it's like for $180 million, and a lot of that is guaranteed. And, you know, it's like, I don't know what our offer would have been, and maybe that'll never come out, but it's not going to be close. It wouldn't have been close in the years or in the dollars. And so I like that in that respect, you see the deal that they signed. I'm fine with it. I'm fine that we didn't do it. I would have felt, you know, if it had been for the Achilles 4 years, I wouldn't have been too hesitant to do it. I don't know if that for sure takes him to age 40 or not, but, yeah, it's still a dagger, man. I like Kirk. Obviously, this era of Vikings football, it didn't get where we wanted it to with the, with the team wins and losses, but, you know, it's still sad to see it end. It's also, I mean, I was already going to do a video because we signed Jonathan Grenard from the Texans, who is essentially going to be the replacement for Danielle Hunter. So Hunter's, I mean, obviously we know Hunter's going to be gone too. So this is a real, you know, we're cutting the cord here on a couple of pretty big time Vikings. I've been front lines of supporting Kirk for years, and I recognize how good of a player he's been for us, and a lot of fucking fans don't, and a lot of fans are just idiots who have not, in 6 years, they haven't fucking figured it out that Kirk's pretty damn good. I don't look down on Kirk for taking this deal. Like, I mean, I still believe, and I I'm already seeing all the people, enough of the people out there saying, oh, see, Kirk was always just about the money. Well, when the money is this, you're going to fucking take that deal. Sorry, you're going to. There's a hometown discount, and then there's just being completely insane. Not to mention the fact that he already had taken less money multiple times to be with the Vikings. Originally, when he signed here, he took less money than the Jets. He took multiple extensions while he was here that kept him from the open market where he would have made more money. There was the deal on the table last offseason that he would have signed for a lot less per year than what he's gotten now. And we didn't sign him. Kwesi didn't want to do it. And that's fine. That's their decision. They want to get onto the future and whatever quarterback situation is going to be. But if it was all about the money for Kirk's whole career, he ain't doing some of the things he's done here. So when you have a deal that overwhelming on the table and security, because too, like, it's a 4-year deal. Now we don't know. I don't know for sure if it's like, okay, guaranteed through like the whole deal or whatever, the whole deal. But this also means Kirk is the Atlanta Falcons starting quarterback uncontested for probably at least 2 or 3 years. If he comes back here, say on a 2-year deal, that's not guaranteed because they're probably drafting a quarterback. You know, so I don't look down on Kirk at all for taking this deal. The people who hate Kirk and they're kind of going to accuse him of just chasing the money, these people didn't like Kirk to begin with. They didn't like Kirk for 6 years. So I don't really care what they have to say. It sucks. I mean, it sucks to see him go, you know. It sucks to have this be over, you know, and I'm hopeful that the next moves that we make it's the right move, because we're going to draft a quarterback. I thought we were going to draft a quarterback even if we did get Kirk back here for a couple years. But now it's the pressure's really going to be on to nail that draft pick. And then there's obviously other guys out there, free agent quarterbacks, the, you know, bridge type guys. None of the names are very appealing. But you know, I think it's 100% we're taking a first round quarterback now. It was, if Kirk did come back, we might not have gone QB, at least early, maybe went defense or something. But now it's 100% we will be taking a quarterback. Boy, it sucks that this is the end, you know. But again, I don't look down on Kirk for taking this deal. This is an overwhelmingly big deal. Like, people can say what they want, but he should take a hometown discount. I'll go to my grave saying that if the Vikings offer or the Falcons offer were close, he comes back here, even if it's the cheaper deal. I will bet my life that the Vikings offer was not even remotely close to this. And Falcons probably had to make it especially big to make sure that Kirk didn't come back here. But the Kirk haters are, I mean, we'll see the fallout of this with the Kirk haters. I mean, they've hated him for 6 years for reasons that even they don't understand, but, you know, they're probably elated. They couldn't wait to have him gone. They've hated him. They think he's the reason. So they blame him singularly for the Vikings not winning a Super Bowl in the last 6 years. You know, that's just the way it is. But, you know, smart Vikings fans like myself understand that, you know, Kirk was a pretty damn good quarterback for the last 6 years for us. I mean, he's, you know, strong case that he's the second best quarterback in the history of the franchise. And, you know, to see him go is painful. This is a sad day for me. You know, I think this is a sad day. I mean, it doesn't mean it has to be like a death knell for the franchise. That's another thing that all the Kirk haters have been saying, like, oh, people who support Kirk, we're afraid that of ever, you know, moving on from Kirk and getting a young quarterback and trying out. That's not even remotely close to true. I'm completely okay with them drafting a quarterback. I would have been okay with them drafting a quarterback even if Kirk did come back. I hope we nail it. I hope if it's JJ McCarthy or, you know, whoever else, should be a little easier to trade up, I would think, now, because Atlanta definitely is not going to be taking a quarterback in the first round, and they're a few picks ahead of us. You know, I would 100% borderline guarantee that they take a QB, unless there's some other goofy move coming out, because, you know, there was talk that maybe Baker Mayfield would come here while he re-signed with Tampa. Russell Wilson signed with Pittsburgh. Everybody else that's left as free agent quarterbacks is a real kind of, at best, a guy you could throw out there for a couple games. I really hope they don't just stick with Nick Mullins and a rookie going to next year. But, yeah, it's a blow. I mean, because again, the people who understand football and who aren't just idiots who believe stupid narratives pushed out by stupid people in the media, I can't even imagine how celebratory it is over at Score North today. These people who just believe stupid shit, stupid narratives that have been long since debunked. I was engaging with some idiot on, I think, what was it, Reddit, just yesterday, bringing up the, oh, he's just a garbage time stat pattern. That's been so debunked over and over, and people just refuse to believe the truth. Like, you know, I'm sad to see Kirk go. I will root for him. You know, there's the belief, of course, that anyone who supports Kirk, oh, they must not even be a Vikings fan. They're just a Kirk fan. No, I'm a Vikings fan. Literally renewed my season tickets last week or a little over a week ago. Not even knowing who the quarterback was going to be, but strange that I did that, even though I'm only a Kirk fan. I will root for Kirk, though. I will root for Kirk Cousins to succeed in Atlanta. We play them next year at the Purple Palace. I will not root for Kirk Cousins in that game. I'll probably wear my Kirk jersey to the game. You know, I'll give him some applause. They introduce him at the start of the game. But after that, I hope we kick his ass. And I hope we kick his ass any other times we play him in the next 4 years. But beyond that, yeah, I'm gonna hope Kirk Cousins succeeds. I don't want him to bring a Lombardi trophy to Atlanta because I want us to get a Lombardi trophy. But, you know, I absolutely hope he succeeds, and I hope this presumably will be the last stop of his career. And I hope he has a really good run there in Atlanta, just not against us. But yeah, this is a sad day. Cause man, I've been just in terms of this, doing videos, I've done more videos about Kirk Cousins than anything else. I mean, I've got a whole playlist of just me addressing some of the stupid narratives and stupid controversies around Kirk Cousins over the last 6 years, or not. I haven't been doing videos for 6 years, but say the last 4 years. You know, I get fired up talking about Kirk because it's a catalyst to rip on stupid fans and stupid media. Where will I find that now? There will be no shortage of stupid fans. Trust me, a lot of these fans who've been banging the drum for years about getting Kirk out of here, they ain't gonna have any patience whatsoever for a rookie quarterback's struggles. Let's say it's J.J. McCarthy and he struggles for the first month of next season, these people are gonna be calling him a bust and demanding that we tank the season, because these are the people who are not fans. The anti-Kirkers are more likely to not be fans than the pro-Kirkers. But, you know, that's kind of it for that year. I mean, Kirk Cousins derangement syndrome, it's leaving us. I'm sure there's going to be some Falcons fans who are probably mad that the Falcons signed Kirk, because they've bought into the media bullshit about him. You know, but if any Falcons fans happen upon this video, trust me, you're getting a damn good quarterback. Now, we don't know for sure on the health thing, that the Achilles thing is a legitimate concern. I mean, he would have gotten even more money if not for the Achilles. He would have gotten well over $200 million in a contract if not for the Achilles. We don't know for sure on the health thing, but if he's healthy, you know, any Falcons fans checking this out, welcome. Subscribe, why not? I do my best. You're getting a damn good quarterback. He's healthy. He's going to be a damn good quarterback. And you got a lot of weapons down in Atlanta. You know, I don't really know much about their defense or anything. I know they're in a pretty weak division. Falcons are definitely going to be my pick to win that division next year. You got a good quarterback now, Falcons. First good one since Matt Ryan. And we'll have to figure our thing out, you know. There will be a future, despite what the fucking Kirk haters say, that, you know, talk about the Kirk Crusaders. Gee, I wonder where they got that term from, fucking assholes in the media. They believe that we're just going to, they think that we think that the Vikings are never going to ever win another football game again without Kirk Cousins. It's not true. We could be a good team next year. I mean, if we hit, we signed Grenard. Seems like a really good signing, kind of like the replacement for Danielle Hunter, a little younger. Obviously, any defensive guys we sign are going to have the blessing of Brian Flores, who I completely trust. And we signed, just before I hit record, we signed some linebacker from the Dolphins, Van Ginkle. We've already bolstered the defense a little bit. We're going to do more. Other signings, obviously. obviously now that Kirk money, there's that dead cap money. That'll be a thing that'll be on the cap for the year. There was, you know, but we were never going to offer enough to where it was kind of going to offset, you know? So, yeah, especially when I saw all the numbers on that deal, I was like, okay, we were never going to sign it. And I could be at peace with that because we were never going to give him that deal. It was never going to happen. So there's no need to be mad. There's no need to be mad at Kirk, because any Vikings fan who is the least bit honest with themselves would have taken that deal if they were in Kirk's shoes. You know what? It's actually getting hot in the car. It's actually a nice day. Put my fucking window down. That's a reason to be positive. It's a nice, not even spring day. Any Vikings fan who is a lying sack of shit, and then unfortunately there's a lot of lying sacks of shit out in Vikings fandom. I deal with some of them every day. You would have taken that deal too. You would have taken this Atlanta deal. And if you say you wouldn't, then you're fucking lying. But I'm completely okay with the Vikings not matching it, or not even, you know, coming at least close enough to get back here. Cause, you know, four years for an aging quarterback, even one who's, you know, when he was hurt last year, he was playing some of the best football of his career. I believe he's going to come back healthy and play very well again. But still, 4 years is a lot to commit. Obviously, the money is a lot to commit. You know, they want, you know, this is, you know, KOC liked Kirk. Kwesi liked Kirk. And, Kirk played his absolute best football as a Viking with Kevin O'Connell. But these guys are new. This is their show now. This isn't Zimmer Spielman anymore, and they want to have their own thing. And if they nail it, like if they nail this first round draft pick quarterback this year, we could be set for a decade plus. And that's awesome. And I hope that does happen. I hope it happens immediately. I hope we get the CJ Stroud of the 2024 draft class. There is the possibility that we don't, though, and that's the scary part for me, is that I don't want to go into the abyss, the QB abyss, which we were in for so long before Kirk. You know, occasionally we would have some decent QB play, but certainly nothing sustainable, nothing that lasted. You know, I would hope, I'm going on too long here, I got stuff to do. I would hope that time will at least convince some of these people who have hated on Kirk Cousins as a sport for the last 6 years that he was actually really good for us. We didn't win a Super Bowl. We didn't make it to an NFC Championship game. It's not on Kirk. It wasn't because his contract was so bad it kept us from signing guys. It had nothing to do with that. It wasn't because he was a choke artist. It's like, you know, you never win every game as a quarterback. He played. He balled out. He was clutch as hell a lot. He was clutch in every single game, but no quarterback is. He was a damn good quarterback. He's one of my, you know, in 30, since 87, so what is that, 36 years, I'm old, 36 years or something like that, 37, whatever, of watching the Vikings, he is in my top 10 favorite Vikings in that era, like, maybe even top 5. I just really like the guy. I like the guy, I like his person, I like his personality, I like how he plays, I like, you know. And the results, his results, I know the team results did not get where we wanted it to get, but it's a team game. It's not about one fucking guy. It's certainly not about one of the guys who was absolutely the best player on our team for 6 years, or one of the best, certainly. And I'm going to scream it until the fucking end of the, till the heat death of the fucking universe, man. Kirk Cousins was a damn good quarterback for the Minnesota Vikings for 6 years. And, you know, he earned his money. People got mad that he got these contracts. He earned his fucking money. A lot of other guys didn't earn their money over the last 6 years with this team. And that had a lot more to do with us not getting the fucking Lombardi than Kirk. And so, I don't know. I mean, there'll be a lot more to talk about with Kirk and just the Vikings in general. There's lots of them. Hell, they might have done something in the time I've been talking. I've been going for, what are we at? Probably a half hour almost. I'm at peace with this because of what the terms of the deal were. We were never going to get him at that price, and you can't, it's, you know, offer he can't refuse, and he can't refuse it. And no sane person would turn down the deal that Kirk Cousins got from the Falcons. And frankly, I'm sure Kirk wasn't thinking this, but why would I want to come back on a big discount in this case to a fucking fan base that has done nothing for 6 years but fucking blame me for everything, lie about me, call me names, call me greedy, call me a choke artist, call me a stat patter, you know, call me every name, every derogatory name imaginable, you know. I'd want to leave too. And I would especially want to leave for that amount of money. So, Kirk ain't going to see this video. But, Kirk, thanks for the 6 years, man. We did have some great times. That fucking 2022 season. I know we didn't win a playoff game, but God damn it, that was one of the most fun seasons I've ever experienced as a Vikings fan. Kirk was a major, major, major part of that. Obviously, the Saints playoff win, that was big. Obviously, a lot of other cool games in there. The Kirko chains thing, that was, the memes even with the guy. It was like all this, it was a memorable era. I know it wasn't Super Bowl era, but we've never had it. So you can't look at it that way. So you just hate every year of Vikings football because those weren't Super Bowl eras too? I mean, come on. It's like, we had some good times. We had some good times in the Kirk era. Not enough. And we didn't get that ultimate, but this was a good move when we picked him up originally. It's a good move when we kept him. And I think ultimately it's probably a good move that we're parting ways now, for especially with those contract terms. So I could go on for days. There will be more to talk about. I'm sure I'll probably end up having to do some sort of thing recapping the reaction to the deal, to him leaving, and kind of what. I'm sure there's going to be. I've already seen it. He was always all about the money. Just shut up. He was not all. If he was all about the money, his whole career, he wouldn't even have played with us for 6 years. He might not have played with us for 1 year. A new era of Vikings football very much is at hand, and sad to see the previous one go. Gonna be hopeful that the next one is even better. But no matter what the next era goes, this was, a fun era of Vikings football, and Kirk got us that. And so I will say, just to finish off, I will say thank you, Kirk Cousins. Thanks for the memories, and good luck in Atlanta.